Hello, welcome back to another video from me, Danielle. Today I'm 35 weeks pregnant, so I thought it's a perfect time to do a pregnancy styling video because the bump is about as big as it's gonna get. It might grow a little bit more in the next month here, but it's pretty large and in charge. So I thought it'd be a good time to get this video out. And without further ado, let's jump right into things. So in making this video, I wanted to do a wide spectrum of different looks. First one being very casual. This is actually what I wore today. But there's a few different ways you can dress this up. So as you see, the base, pretty simple. Nice pair of joggers, which these are the Isabel Maternity brand from Target, but I've had a couple different ones from Amazon too this pregnancy. All have been great. This is also Isabel Maternity on top. It's just a tank top, and then a Shein sports bra. This is very typical of what I wear because if I get hot, just take this off, sports bra, joggers, you're good to go. But you can dress this look up quite a bit. Typically, what I do like to do is throw on a jean jacket. I think it is very, very casual, very put together if you wear a nice little jean jacket over an outfit like this. So this one is one that I have worn a lot. Well, yeah, look, I got a headband in there. This is from Amazon. This is one of the most comfy, best jean jackets I've ever worn. Very well built, and I believe it was like 25 bucks when I bought it. So it was super cheap, but it has lasted now for going on a year this fall, so no fading, anything, and I wash this thing all the time because kids are always getting it dirty, so it's a great look, great outfit here. Okay, all I changed here, put on a sweatshirt. This is a sweatshirt that I wear all the time when I'm not pregnant, but note the look. So it's tight around the belly, so I think it's very flattering. From the front, you don't really look that pregnant. I think it's really nice to have a tighter sweatshirt that just fits right underneath the belly. I wear this with leggings a lot. But here's the real kicker of this look. I know not everyone's about vests. I've become a vest person. My brother bought me this Nike vest for Christmas. I'm not even a Nike fan, but I love this vest. I think it's an extra large because, you know, when boys buy clothes, they don't know what to buy you. So he bought me an extra large, but it has been wonderful for pregnancy because it's huge, fits really nice. I even can zip it up. Like, it actually is a practical vest, not just a fashion vest. So it has come in handy a lot. I don't typically zip it up, but, you know, it's pretty good. And if you're a mom and you have a lot of different things that are in your pockets, trust me, you're gonna be all about this. We were at a restaurant the other day. One of the kids brought Duplos in. I just pulled this out of the vest. It's been in there, and I've worn this vest since. I didn't even know it was in there. That's how comfy this vest is. You don't even know what's in your pockets. Big proponent of the vest. And it doesn't have to be a Nike vest. I mean, typically, like, I don't go for Nike stuff. I probably would have, if I would have bought it, just bought an Amazon vest. So you always have that option, and Amazon has a lot of nice vests, and nice vest options. So keep that in mind too. So the next option I wanted to show you is a non-maternity dress, but it is a type of dress that I think is very flattering on most pregnancy body types, which is anything bodycon. Now this is not a maternity bodycon, which I'll actually show one next because I do like them a little better. This is one that I bought years ago now at a Dillard's outlet store locally, and it is very comfortable. I've worn it through all my pregnancies, and it is just so stretchy and such a nice length. I mean, look how long it is. It's a midi style dress, and I don't really wear it that much when I'm not pregnant because I don't like this length of dress on me when I'm not pregnant. But when I'm pregnant, this is great. With this bump, so huge, so far out, so large and in charge, it is very nice to have the extra length, and you kind of can ruche it up, ruche it down, however you feel comfortable wearing it. But it's a great dress. I mean, it really is a nice staple. And stripes, guys. Do stripes because it just makes you look narrower this way, which is always a good thing. Because from the side, you're going to be huge. I mean, you got a child inside of you. You know what's going to happen. But from the front, you can always do illusions, which is why I like ruching on the side because it has that illusion. But the lines also create an illusion that really just makes you look nice. So keep that in mind when you're shopping for maternity dresses. Horizontal lines are typical designs that you see, and that's because they are super flattering to the eye. Oh, and also wear black. Black's always a good choice too. Okay guys, this is one of my new favorite maternity dresses that was sent to me by Isabel Maternity. I actually have two dresses from them in this haul. So thank you for sending those over to me. But they are beautiful and just so well built. Now this one does not have the built-in ruching. So if you're a person who doesn't like that, it's actually a great maternity dress for that. But it has the extra space in the bump that it creates that ruching, which I like, especially at the end of pregnancy, little extra room, a little more comfortable. And I know this dress is gonna fit literally from 20 weeks when you just start to show until the end of pregnancy, because it is so stretchy. Sorry, I got a baby leg like moving around and it's not very comfortable. This is a beautiful dress. Color is gorgeous. I do think a plain solid dress with a nice V neckline looks gorgeous when you're pregnant. And with this, I think you could dress it up or down. So let's grab the trusty old jean jacket, why don't we? So I think if you do something like this, just put a jean jacket on, this is a go to lunch, go to brunch, you're set for the day outfit. And because of the slit here, it's a longer dress, but it does make it really comfortable to walk because, hey, you got that movement, got that area that you can move. But I do think there's a few other things you can do with this dress beyond just throwing this jacket on. If you had a nice blazer to throw on, I think it could be very work appropriate. In fact, I think I have my blazer down here, so let me grab it. Oh yeah, this is definitely something I would wear to a conference. I'm actually mad I didn't have this dress earlier in pregnancy, because I was going to a bunch of conferences. This would have been the look and would have had people looking. Eyes would have been turning. I do like all eyes on me, I'm not gonna lie. I know that sounded very conceited. But I do like to look nice when I go places. This blazer is from Amazon, super cheap, super comfortable, and I am not a stiff, stuck up type blazer person. I don't like the huge shoulder pads and the really stiff material. This one's loose, nice, flowy, and honestly, at almost 9 months pregnant, still fits me very nicely. This is the other dress that I have from Isabel Maternity. It's very outside of what I usually wear for a maternity dress. Not really about the high empire waists, and I usually don't wear something as short as this, but it is a gorgeous dress. The material feels so freaking nice too. And if you are a little not as pregnant as I am, I think that this is a very good look. I even have worn it, like I wore it the day after Valentine's Day. I wore it with leggings, and then it's almost like a tunic type shirt dress, especially at this point in pregnancy. But I think for spring, now that it's like right around the corner, thank goodness, so glad it's getting warm out. This is gonna be a nice dress for anyone who's pregnant for the summer, springtime, because it's so lightweight. And honestly, it is beautiful. It's a beautiful dress. And I think it's so cute. I'm not usually a cutesy type. I usually go for more like sexy type things. But I do like to go on that cute edge every once in a while. And this is a good little taste of the cuteness that I crave. And empire waists are always a good thing in pregnancy if you want to be comfortable and not have anything hugging the belly, because some days it is hard to have material tight on the belly, so I get that. If you saw my Amazon maternity try-on back when I was, I think, 30 weeks pregnant or something, I did it, you would know this dress I've been wearing since 16, 17 weeks pregnant, and I loved it then, and I freaking still love it now. It is such a good dress. Why I like this dress. There's a couple of elements here that make it very flattering for pregnancy at any point of your pregnancy. For starters, when you just become pregnant and the bump starts to show, so you know, end of first trimester, beginning of second, that's usually when you start to get like a little extra weight, and you don't quite have the pregnancy bump yet, so it can be like, is she pregnant, is she not? This dress is gonna make you look good and kinda make people know you're pregnant too, because it has the ruching, which is always like a sign of maternity clothes. So, one reason why this is good, buttons all the way down, draws your eyes in, center of your body, makes you look more narrow. The V-neck makes you look more narrow. But here's the kicker here. This ruching, so freaking flattering on any pregnancy belly. I mean, it covers up anything you might be having on going on love handle wise, because sometimes you're a little wider in pregnancy. Maybe the baby's laying sideways. Like right now, I swear he's laying a little bit weird because I'm feeling him all over on this side and it's a little strange. I wish I would have had this dress in my last pregnancies just because I had some good ones, good ruched ones, but they all are longer, like the other ones I've shown. And this one is like a good length, right above the knee. This is where I typically wear a dress. Love the color, and it came in a couple different colors on Amazon. I got everything linked below, so you'll be able to look through anything that I have in here that I could find the link for. Some of it's a little older, some of it's local, but you know what I mean. but I'll have everything like that I can or something similar to it. And yeah, basically this is just a great dress in general, and super comfortable. The cotton material is very nice, and it is just very flattering. Oh, and one other ruching detail, the butt ruching here, back and butt. I thought it was a little strange at first, but if you notice, it really just draws everything in even more and gives you a very nice shape for pregnancy, which confidence in pregnancy, I am all about. Be confident in your body, dress it, because hey, you're only pregnant for a couple times in your life, maybe, so dress it, show it off. The next things I have are two bodysuit options. They also have been featured in previous maternity haul videos that I've done, but I think a bodysuit is a freaking great option for pregnancy, except when you gotta pee. Then it gets a little more difficult. But if you're just trying to look cute, don't care that it's gonna take an extra minute or two to pull it down and pee, you know what? I think it's worth it, in my opinion, because I wanna look good. I got this on Shein back in October, like, you know, when I was pretty freshly pregnant, just, you know, in the first trimester, maybe right outside of it. But I think it's very nice. It is black, very flattering, pretty comfortable, and I'm surprised that it fits so well at this point in pregnancy. Didn't think it would. I thought it might be a little tight, but it actually is more comfortable now than it was when I wore it back when I was 16, 17 weeks pregnant. I do like to style this in a couple different ways. One is wrapping something around your waist. Simple and easy. In fact, I should get a fanny pack because that's typically what I do, but I also do like to wrap sweatshirts and things. This one's a crop sweatshirt, so it doesn't like cover the butt as much as something else would, but wrapping it underneath the belly just really shows off the belly a little bit. And then if you're cold, you can put this on. So here's my fanny pack. This is my pink one. I have a black one too. This is cute. This is she's chic. She's a mom who's going to the park. This is a good outfit if you're a spring pregnancy mom or if you are a summer pregnant mom, because you always need your fanny pack. There's no pockets in this bodysuit. My other bodysuit doesn't have pockets, so you gotta do what you gotta do, you know? Here is the long version of the bodysuit, also spaghetti strap, but I'm pregnant, so I don't deal with, you know, strapless bras. I'm just wearing a normal bra. But this one, again, something I'd worn at the beginning of pregnancy to the end, and I cannot tell you how excited I am to wear this after pregnancy. I think this is gonna look very sexy. I'm excited to see what it looks like. But you can wear it just like this. I have done that before when it is just warm out and, you know, it's fine. When we went to California for Thanksgiving, this was literally like an outfit I wore half the time we were there. I mean, look at that. You can't get a much rounder belly than that, right? But again, you put on this fanny pack with it, you got a nice outfit here. I mean, this is functional and pretty damn stylish, if you ask me. Another thing I like to wear with this is a longer jacket. So I have my nice little rose arm jacket. I thrifted this at a place called Crossroads back in the day, many years ago now. But again, looks beautiful. I think it's very casual and comfortable. And for anyone who's pregnant, you know that you always want layers because sometimes it's really hot, sometimes it's really cold. You can layer this up in about any type of jacket that you want, and you're gonna be warm. You're definitely gonna be warm enough. So this one I included because I've had a few people ask me if maternity jeans are necessary in pregnancy. Honestly, it's preference. I liked them this pregnancy because I was traveling and I liked having the option of not just leggings or a dress. You can wear jeans too. But I've had two other pregnancies where I didn't wear jeans. Didn't wear jeans at all. But I do love these ones from Amazon. And I just paired them with, literally, this is what I wore to most conferences, a black shirt and then black jacket. And the thing that I look for in most maternity jeans is don't have the pull over the belly. I find those to be super uncomfortable. Do the little like bands on the side. I think that's nice because you can still tuck in shirts and it doesn't look weird. But also, it just looks a little more put together. You can put a belt on, a little more variety there than when you pull over the belly, you have to have a shirt go over it. So that's my tip if you're looking for maternity jeans. Here is a look that I wore the heck out of last pregnancy. Haven't used it as much this pregnancy because I've been a little lazier, honestly, with how I've been dressing, but I love this. So basically, you just wear leggings or tights with a bodycon dress. This is a bodycon dress that is pretty see-through, so I always have to wear leggings with it. But you just tie a shirt over it. which this is just a button-down shirt. I think that's the easiest to do. Some people do t-shirts, then they tie them up. Not really a fan, because I'm not even a fan of t-shirts, like, in most cases in life. But I do like the button-down look. You put some long necklaces with this, nice earrings. It really is nice and dressed up. You could wear this to work, and I think it'll look awesome. You also can wear a sweater over it, which I do quite a bit. A crop sweater looks really nice. So that's another option for you. But I think this is such a versatile look. Just black leggings, black bodycon dress, and throw whatever over it, and you're going to just be good to go with so many different maternity outfits and looks based off of clothes that you didn't think that you could maybe wear right now. You can make them work by tying them above the belly instead of over the belly, because they'll fit that way. This is my last look, mainly because I'm getting tired and the baby's kicking me pretty intensely. But this one I call Sporty Barbie Pregnant Lady. Kind of a long name, Sporty Barbie Pregnant Lady. But this is a nice summer outfit. In fact, when I was pregnant in the summer, my first time around, my first child, I wore this outfit a lot. High-waisted, maternity shorts. These ones are just some cheap Amazon ones. Probably with a little better quality than these ones. But I've just had these for a while, so I wear them all the time. I have the nice belly covered with the maternity shorts. Keeps it nice and held in, nice and tight. Put on a nice sports bra. This one is a nursing sports bra, maternity bra. Really, really like it. And then throw on a vest, throw on a sweatshirt, anything like that to do your layers. You always want to have your layers. I think it's very cute. And I think this outfit alone, like when it's hot out in the summer, I'm all about just wearing nice comfy shorts and a sports bra. That's literally my summer attire all the time. It doesn't matter if I'm pregnant or not pregnant. So being pregnancy, this is an A+ outfit for me. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope that it was helpful, giving you some good outfit ideas for maternity. I know my first pregnancy around, I was a little lost about what would look good, what wouldn't. So I thought it could be a nice informative video for anyone who's looking for some inspiration. I always love watching styling videos when I'm pregnant. So if you're like me, maybe you liked it. Please give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below what your favorite look was, or maybe one that you're going to try, because I'm always interested and it really does help my channel if you do some interaction. Like the video, subscribe to my channel for more content. Please keep watching the videos. Let me know what you want to see more of, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.